So after cleaning this as best as I could, as I was blow drying the drums here, and I believe it was this left one, a little piece of lint come flying out. So I do want to take these drums off and take a better look at them. So again, I need to take a picture of this before I take anything off. Especially, like now I'm going to do this. I think I'll get a separate bowl for these screws because these are a little bit... I want to keep them separate from the cover screws. So I'm going to take a picture that I could look at later on. And I better make sure the flash is on. And what I'll do is get pictures over here too as well. And I'll keep my camera handy in case I missed a picture. So first of all, this here, I believe, has to come off first. As I was looking at the service manual, this little piece of metal does have to come off. And then this, the sub drum comes off first. There's an E-snap ring and then a washer underneath it. And I do see some lint in here and there. So if it's right there, I could have that inside the drum. It could be on the shaft that's holding the drum too. So let me just see real quick. I may not have to take these off. But yeah, this, I do see how this will have to come off. And you have to bear down really hard. So as I look, these screws got a little washer on them. I'll do one side first so I could look at the other side as well. Or if you have a second carriage, you could do both of them at the same time. Okay, so now I need to get that little E-clip off. You need a small screwdriver, and then you're going to wedge it in that little hole and just pull it out. Now, I've lost some of these before, so if I could keep my fingers close there, this is not going to go flying, and I'll have a hard time losing it. There we go. So there is that. Actually, I'm going to get a piece of paper towel because these are a little greasy and I don't want to lose that grease. So I'll put that there. That goes on the drum. Now, let's see. Okay, so the sub drum does come off. I do see some gunk in there. And there is a little lint thing right here. Actually, it's like a ball of lint. So I got to get another piece of paper towel here to wipe this off, or a clean rag if you have one. You want to be careful with that. Now I can't get that up because this is in the way. So I am going to have to take these off, but I'm not sure. Oh yeah, I can get to it. After I get this rod off, I got three screws there to take this metal piece off and then get that drum off, because more than likely, and I could see even on this shaft here, there's not really much, but sometimes you don't need that much and it will cause problems. Of course, it would have been good if I had rubber gloves on, that way I don't have to wash my hands with Dawn later on. So let's see. If I loosen that up. Actually, I want to use my magnetized screwdriver so I don't lose this. Now, this is the gold screw. And the washer. I'm going to put that washer right back on there. And because it is greasy, I'm going to put it there. I'm going to take the spring off. Well, what happens is the white thing's coming up. So I could lift that up. And I could see how those rods go in there. Again, I'm going to push that over there. Take this rod off. I'm leaving the spring on there, although before I lose the spring, I'm going to put that in the little bowl. Okay, so now I've got two screws here. And I'm sure these are factory tightened down. And then I got to get to that one other screw in there. So this metal piece will come off. Now yours may not have this metal piece. Yours may look a little differently. And I got to get a different screwdriver because that one there is not going to do it. I thought I could move it out of the way, but there we go. Ah, it clicked over. So my magnetized one again. And what I can do is, as I'm taking these screws out, I could place them in order. Over here, so when I put them back on, I know which ones to put on. So now let's see. Okay, that metal thing comes out and it's actually into the drum. Okay, so now that shaft is not that bad, and even the drum itself doesn't look that bad. It was the sub drum that I had the problem with. But let me wipe these down, and then I'm just going to start putting that side back together.